Australian actor Jon Blake has died.
He'd survived 25 years with severe brain injuries after a car crash on his way home from filming the classic movie The Light Horseman. He died from pneumonia, aged 52.
He was the rising star whose career was cut short by a tragic car accident. Jon Blake had become a fan favourite on shows like The Restless Years, Anzacs and Patrol Boat before starring in a string of movies that had him being called the next Mel Gibson.
I don't know if you can understand me, but I'd very much appreciate it if you'd give me the chance to blow your bloody head apart.
But in December 1986, as he headed home from filming that final scene in The Light Horseman, his car collided with a truck and he was left paralysed with severe brain damage. Just a few weeks ago, the future was looking bright as he moved in with his son Dustin to a new home and a new beginning after 25 years of being confined to a darkened room as legal battles went on around him.
He's doing good, finally.
John's mother, Mascot, who'd looked after him for 21 years, died leaving the house he lived in to a deregistered doctor she'd met at a leagues club. Dustin had to battle to be given the right to look after his own dad.
How would you sum up what the future's going to be?
Very bright, very happy. So, yeah, a lot better. There's actually a purpose in life now.
One of the last things John did was finally see the movie he made so long ago when it returned to the big screen for a limited season. His funeral will be held later this week. Jon Blake was 52.
And Angela Bishop joins us now. And as you said in this report, you did spend quite a bit of time with Jon Blake and his family recently. And his son, Dustin, you spoke with him today.
I did. And Dustin's too upset, of course, to come on camera today. But he really did want me to share his sincere and heartfelt thanks to all the carers, volunteers and nurses who helped look after John over the last 25 years, and you can imagine how many wonderful people that did involve. I did see John in hospital late last week and got to say my goodbyes, and I suppose the one thing we can take away from this is that his last years, his last months there with Dustin and his fiancée Bree were filled with love and warmth and hope. So his funeral will be later this week.
Thank you, Angela Bishop.